And let's talk more about those challenges. I mean, not enough contact tracers, and then getting people to actually talk on the phone to the contact tracers that we have.
Allison, I mean, when you're really judging the effectiveness of contact tracing, it really depends on whether you're talking about stopping the virus completely or really stemming or slowing down the spread. So when it comes to stopping the virus completely, of course, contact tracing isn't good enough alone, partly because you saw in places like Michigan, those contact tracers report that only 2/3 of the people are actually answering their phones when they're called. And then nationwide, Dr. Fauci said back in June that only about 50% of people are picking up the phone. So it's really a question of time, because when it comes to slowing down the virus, it is, of course, better than just quarantining and just testing alone. But when time is the key ingredient, the focus is on making sure that you can reach those people and they can know that they have COVID, and also to stop them from spreading the virus without knowing. Allison?
Morgan, how are states working together to track and trace coronavirus infections? Is there sort of a coordinated effort here?
I mean, the short answer is no. States are effectively on their own. In fact, the closest thing you have to really national coordination are those CDC guidelines. But right now, there are bills that are being debated in Congress, one of which would allocate $100 billion for testing and contact tracing. So there is hope that those contact tracers may actually get the funds that they say that they need to continue being effective. Allison?
Well, we know how important that is. Morgan, great to see you. Thanks so much.